in the name of Jesus. Please be seated for a minute. When welcome into his presence again this Sunday, I believe that it is somebody's turn today. You didn't hear me. They say it is turn by turn. I said, I believe it is somebody's turn today. Amen. You said amen, so shall it be. Amen. In Jesus' name. Amen. Jesus has been healing the blind. But there's this particular day that a man was brought to him. His friends just asked him to please just lay hands on him and he will receive his sight. That's what they thought. But when they got to Jesus, Jesus took a look at this man and knew he needed more than that. So he took him by the hand. He didn't get his sight. He was touching him. He took him out of town, all the way out of town. And when he got out of town, he began to make clay, put his sputum on it, anointing, and anointed the eyes of the man. And people may be wondering, how come others got theirs by just laying of hands? Some, he just spoke the word, like blind Bartimaeus. So you want sight? Receive your sight. And he got it. But this one, he didn't get it by sight. He didn't get it by holding his hand. He didn't get it until he came out of town. And he began to make clay to anoint his eyes. Even then, Jesus says, go and wash and come back. The man came back. Jesus asked him, can you see? He said, well, I see men, but they are like trees, you know, working. It means it wasn't clear. There had to be a second anointing. And the man said, now I can see clearly. We've been on the mountain from the beginning of the month. It is possible that the first time you came, you just took a look at the altar. You got your own miracle. It's possible that the second Sunday you came, that was when you got your miracle. But I believe, God, that for as many as have not tapped into this that the Lord has given to us this month, which is that stronghold must be pulled down. It doesn't matter whether it's physical or spiritual, material, financial, emotional. God says it must come down. That's why I'm believing God for someone that maybe you didn't get it on the prayer mountain. You didn't get it the second Sunday. It's your turn today. We have in the house someone who's been here before, that God has used mightily here before. All the way from South Africa. All the way from South Africa. Is he here with a mandate from the Lord to destroy the remaining strongholds? Those who have received partial miracle, your miracle will be full today. If you believe it, say better amen. Amen. My pleasure to bring to the microphone the man of God all the way from South Africa has been kind to come to us today. Reverend Gideon Akindele. Give it to Jesus. Give it to Jesus. You're welcome, sir.
Let somebody shout hallelujah. Something is about to happen to you. I want all the witches in the whole Festac and Lagos to hear your voice. Let somebody shout hallelujah. I want to decree to 125 people here, in the name that is above every other name, whatever has held down your ancestors before you came, as you scream the loudest amen, they are destroyed right now. Let me hear your amen like a thunder. Every stubborn battle in your life that has vowed that you will not move to the next level, I stand in my prophetic office to declare today that they are giving up over your life in the name of Jesus. Are you ready for a victory this morning? Your amen will be a weapon for you this morning. Are you ready for victory this morning? Lift your hands to heaven. I'd like you to take that song. You are great. You are great. You are great. You are great. You are great.
You are great.
Everybody, come on, let's sing it to him.
You are great.
Everything.
Everything written about you is great.
Lift your voice, everybody.
You are great.
You are great.
You are great.
Oh Lord.
You are great.
Walk upon the sea.
You are great.
Raise the dead.
You are great.
Everything,
everything written about you is great.
Demons tremble at your presence.
Come on.
Demons tremble at your presence.
Can I get worshippers in the house?
God will
say, what a mighty God will say.
Glory, glory, oh. Hallelujah.
Glory, glory,
hallelujah.
Everything.
Hey.
Everything written about you is great.
Demonstrate your presence, Lord.
Demonstrate.
Come on, let's go.
You are great. You are great.
You are great.
You are great.
You are great.
You are great.
Come on.
You are great.
You are great. Somebody come on.
You are great.
Oh,
you are great.
Everything
written about you. Woo!
You are great, yes you are.
Woo!
Holy one.
Somebody just worship him this morning.
Walk upon the sea,
yeah.
And raise the dead.
Hallelujah!
Reign in majesty, mighty Lord.
Everything written about you.
Go again, come on.
Ha ha ha. Holy one,
thank you, Jesus.
Walk upon the sea,
yeah.
Raise the dead.
Somebody lift your hands to him and worship.
Woo!
Come on.
Mighty God,
hey.
Everything,
everything written about you
is great. Come on.
Oh, you are great.
You are great. One more time. You are great.
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 So great.
You are great. You are great. You are great. You are great. Everything written about you.
You are
the mighty God.
Hey.
The healer told me.
Woo! alagbara ni olodojulo leje alagbara ni olodojulo leje alagbara. Yes, you are the Lord.
Yeah.
Oh, you are. Yes, you are the Lord. Ah, Kalabaya Nama. Oh, yes, you are the Lord. Lift your voice. Come on.
Oh, oh. Yes, you are the Lord.
Without the instrument.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes, you are the Lord.
Everybody, come on.
Oh,
let them hear
yes,
you now.
Yes, you are the Lord.
Declare his lordship over your matter.
Oh,
two more times. Everybody.
Yes, you are the Lord.
Let the devil hear you this
morning.
Somebody sing
yes,
it.
You are the Lord.
One more time, everybody.
Yes, you are the Lord.
Oh,
yes, you are the Lord.
Are you sure you are declaring it to him?
Come on.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are.
Yes, you are the Lord.
You are the Lord.
Beautiful for our situation.
Everybody, come on.
You are the joy of the whole world.
Woo!
You are the great and mighty God. So greatly to be praised. Beautiful for our situation.
Yeah, come on.
You are the joy of the whole world.
One more time.
You are the great and mighty God.
I want to see the heat. Come on.
So greatly to be praised.
Come on. Hallelujah! and sing it to him.
Alleluia.
Lift your hands to him somehow. The glory of God is so heavy in this house this morning. Put me on string. Lift up your two hands, everybody. Let's worship.
Alleluia.
The anointing is here right now. Come on. Woo! Lift your hands to him, somebody. The Shekinah glory is hanging on some people's head right now. Lift your voice and worship him from the depth of your heart. I'd like you to celebrate your next level because something is about to happen. Woo! Woo! Manenenemoko Santa. Manenenemaka basota la bahaya. Elenemoko Santo la bahaya. Are you sure you are worshiping him? Call him any name you want to call him. He is the Adagamakba Roye. The Eminitinja Minimashe Baru. The Jehovah Overdo. Jehovah Ebenezer. Our shield and our buckler. Our very present help in the time of trouble. Woo! Come on, you have 30 seconds. If you let the devil shut your mouth this morning, you are not ready for a change. You are not ready for an elevation. Forget your problem. Forget your challenges. Break forth into his presence. Don't mind the person standing to your right and to your left. The angels of God are moving around. Woo! Ebume! Ebume! Woo! Shilenabokosa! I feel the anointing of the Holy Ghost, my God. Casting crown, lifting hands, bowing hearts, it's all God to do. Casting crown.
Adonai,
this morning, we surrender ourselves to you. We are in the Holy Ghost theater. We want you to work on our cases. We want you to settle our matters. We want you to answer our enemies on our behalf. We want you to visit our villages. We want you to visit all the evil altars. We want you to give us the victory that no one can give to us. Lord, I commend myself to you this morning, that you will use me beyond my imagination. You will anoint every vocal cord, every word that proceeds from my mouth, and everyone that hear the sound of my voice through the city or right here in the house. My Father, you will deliver them from every oppression. You will save them from every oppression. You will give to them their inheritance. Lord, answer my prayers over their lives, even as they scream the loudest amen this morning. Thank you, mighty God. Mighty God that does mighty things. And you say, glorious things shall you do in our midst. Do mighty things in our midst. And let all the glory be yours. Let the devil take the shame. In Jesus' priceless name we pray. Somebody let me hear you shout hallelujah. The devil that allow you to escape to come is in trouble this morning, because he has failed gallantly again. Let me hear your amen louder. Amen. Let me quickly appreciate my most referred mentor, and also he's a father to me and to my family. I do not take this privilege for granted, Daddy. And I know that the belief that you have in me, you will not be disappointed. One of the things that endears me to you is your largeness of heart. I'm not saying this because you are here. I'm saying this because some of us, you have affected us even from far. We wish that we are not called to start a church. Maybe we'll have been one of your associates in this place. And I want to say thank you for this awesome privilege. Thank you. I celebrate you. Church, please help me to celebrate my mentor, my father, my pastor, my coach, our PICP. Thank you, sir. Proverbs 3. God bless you, sir. I celebrate you. And wherever mommy is, I salute her and I send my love and regard to her, wherever she is. And we celebrate the grace of God also on our life. Let me quickly also appreciate all my fathers and my mothers in the house, the pastors, the elders, the ministers. God bless you. Come on, let's celebrate this group of generals. Thank you so much. I celebrate you, man. Celebrate you, sirs. Glory to God. Also, can you please celebrate yourself this morning? Yes. Yes. Glory to God. The reason why I took time to greet is because so that I will have little time to share. Because you must be careful when you have your mentor seated and he's sitting to listen to you. He can pick everything. So I think I've spent some good time. So the rest of the time, the Holy Ghost will help me. Let's give Jesus a clap offering one more time. Second Corinthians chapter 10 verse 3. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. This understanding will help you to repackage yourself and to know where you should stand when you are throwing attack. Verse 4 now says, For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty. Somebody say mighty. Louder than your neighbor, say mighty. Mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. If you look at the scripture very well, these strongholds are so strong that if you don't root them through God, you may not be able to have a good result. If you think your energy level can fight your battle, you have failed before starting the battle. If you think your connection can fix your battle, you are the greatest mumu in the history of life. And if you ever think what your father gave you in the village before you came to Lagos will be your sustaining ability in Lagos, only if the witches of West Festac handle you, you will know that khaki no be leather. But let me tell you, the victory we are talking about is incontestable victory, which Jesus has purchased for us. And that is why I'm going to be ministering on what I've captured, engaging your inheritance through faith. Engaging your inheritance through faith. 1 John chapter 5, verse 4, put us in a very right perspective about our victory in Christ. For whatsoever, if you look at that word, it's not for whosoever. It's a for whatsoever. So, including your animals, including anything that is arrogated to you positively, as long as you are born of God, you have overcome the world. And this is the victory that overcome the world, even our faith. That is to say, life is not a game of funfair. Life is a place of warfare. This understanding will help you to know how to place value on your contacts with people. Because not everybody that says good morning to you actually means the morning is good for you. If you think every teeth that is opened towards you are sent to you, you have deceived yourself. A lot of complimentary that we share with each other do not go down to the bottom of the heart of the other party. And so you must know that you are in a field where battles are being struck on a daily basis. Why? Because you have a glorious destiny. Because you have a destiny that is full of envy. You have a destiny that is full of series of bright colors. For whomsoever he predestinated to call. And whosoever he called, he justified. And whosoever he justified, he do what? He glorified. So you are not an ordinary person. That is why the battle is becoming fierce. I've never seen how potent an arm robber or arm robbers are. When they see mad people, they don't rob them. Mad people don't run from robbers. It is robbers that run away from mad people. Because even when you say, hands up, he bring out his own gun with his hand. You say, come on, get out. You say, you two, get out. Because he's fearless. And they look at him, there is nothing to rob because the enemy has already robbed him already. Why do you put gates in your house? Why do you fence your houses? It is because there are treasures in that house. Oh boy, in South Africa, they robbed us 3 times. The third one, they brought a very long gun in the afternoon and trying to break into, but the Holy Ghost chased them back. I was away. I told my wife, I said, sweetheart, now, all my electronics. Now, with yourself and my son, move. Go and stay somewhere because life is important. Now, I wouldn't have said, no, stay there, don't mind them. They just came to play, don't mind them. No. Because the more they attack, the more value your destiny commands. Can I prophesy to 125 people here? in the name that is above every other name, you will not lose any battle anymore. Somebody may wonder, why am I not getting married? It is because your marriage is a threat. It is because God knows, the devil also knows, that the moment that episode of your life comes to bear, your life will start to fly, and the devil does not want you to move forward. But it's a gallant failure. He's a liar of all time. Because whatsoever God has predestined, nothing can disrupt it. Can I prophesy to you? In this very year 2016, your star will shine. Your glory will rise. You will move forward than your neighbors. You will acquire things that your certificate cannot give to you. Can I hear your amen like a thunder? So if your life will gain a meaning, and if you will want to see your dream come to pass, you must be ready to become a fighter. If you are not a fighter, then anything that the enemy has programmed against you will be successfully done in your life. Only fighters win. When you engage, that is when you begin to see action. Hear this, beloved. What you don't confront, you cannot conquer. What you don't resist has the right to remain. In 1 John chapter 5, verse 19. 1 John chapter 5, verse 19 will help you understanding to know the community you are surrounded with. And we know that we are of God. And the whole what? The whole what? So it's not only first attack alone. The whole world lieth in wickedness. I have been in a transport vehicle many years back. And I sat with a demonic entity who sits in the bus to use the body contact to suck blood. And many of the people that are fall victim, they go out, but by the time they return, they are practically empty. Because while they were using body contact in the bus, somebody was busy working on their case. But when you are too hot for the enemy to handle, they will be the one to drop from the bus, not you. Can I prophesy to somebody here? If your amen can be the loudest, let your life catch fire. Let your business catch fire. Let your marriage catch fire. Say with me, say, I'm no more an experiment for the devil. Louder than your neighbor, say, I'm no more an experiment for the devil. First John chapter 3, verse 8. First John chapter 3, verse 8. Remember, we are engaging our inheritance through faith. He that committed sin is of the devil, for the devil sinned from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. So the target of Jesus in your life is to destroy all that the devil has used his lifespan to do against you. Hear this. The moment you are in Christ, your heritage speaks of victory. You don't contend to become victorious. Even, you see, when a match is about to start, even the referee does not have right to know how the match will go. Am I correct? Soccer fan, am I correct? But in this game, the greatest referee is our God. And he already knows how the match will play out. We have finished the first half. We are now in the second half. And it looks as if you are losing out. Ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, that devil is a liar. First half does not determine victory in a match. It is what happened in the second half that determined victory. Now, let me prophesy in this strength. Before December 25th, if your amen can be the loudest, you will swim in abundance. You will swim in strength millions. Can I shock you? The favor that is bigger than your certificate in this second half of the year, my God, we give it to you. Let me prophesy to you, the nations that you are yet to travel to, in this second half, if you are a believer, you are the one I'm prophesying. I command the gate of those nations to be opened for you. Listen, let me prophesy to you. They say you can't get married. This year you will get married. This year you will get married. Look at your amen. Look at your amen. I said this year you will get married. That project that is still crawling, in this second half of the year, you know, God told me, said, declare. As I'm declaring, the spiritual missile is going into the atmosphere. Any quarter I send the word to, it's not going to return back to me void. I prophesy every project anywhere in Lagos, outside Lagos, that is yet to be completed, I prophesy within the next 3 months, receive divine favor. Receive divine help. Can I hear your amen like a thunder? Quickly, how do we start our journey into victory? How? Because this is what Jesus came to do. He said, for this purpose, he came to destroy the works of the devil. Meaning, you're going to be having things that you never fought for. You're going to be living in houses that you never paid for. You're going to be driving cars that you never bought. Look at your amen. Come on, say a better amen. To start this journey, you must be wired and furnished with the right knowledge. 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 11. Please follow me carefully. I'm about to close. 2 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 11. Lest Satan should get an advantage of us. For we are not ignorant. Ignoramus in the house. Be careful. For we are not ignorant of his devices. Eleboshaya. Meaning not only one device. Devices. You catch him here, he's doing another one. You stop him here, he's doing another one. So, if you are not current, the enemy will atron you and do some certain things that will trap you in life. So, to start this journey into victory, your knowledge capacity must increase. You must be ready to know how the enemy works around you. You must be acquainted with the knowledge on what is happening presently. What are the things that you must know? You must know exactly what the problem is. Remember, when the axe fell, the prophet did not come and get to the water and say, abracadabra, 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 wherever you are, you axe, come up, come up. No, that will have been display of the highest ignorance. He said, show me where it fell. When you go before your doctor, and he said, doctor, I just don't know how my body feels. Now, the doctor pull out a sheet with his pen. Begin to ask you some cogent question. Because until he himself is aware of what is wrong with you, his performance will be questioned. Oh yeah, somebody did not hear me. Until a doctor know exactly what is wrong with you, there is virtually nothing he can do. He said, I just don't know. He said, how are you feeling? I just don't know. The thing is just shaking me jiggy jiggy. He said, where? I just don't know. I just see that the thing is shaking me jiggy jiggy. Please, sir, where? I just don't know. The thing is just shaking me jiggy jiggy. Ah. The doctor will pack you aside as a project to be visited later. In fact, if the doctor is wise, like the people of the world, he say, you better take him to the village. Because here, we only treat the sicknesses. We know. Is it in the head? I don't know. In the leg, I don't know. In the heart, I don't know. At the back, I don't know. They put you under scan. Scan can't scan anything. The prophet said, where is the axe? The axe. Where did it fall? He said, here. He said, matter settled. Cut a stick, threw it there. The stick fell up. Listen, I prophesy to you. Everything the enemy has robbed in your life, everything that the enemy has robbed in your relationship, there are people, there are 125 people here right now that the Lord is sending me to. In the name that is above every other name, if your amen can be sharper than your neighbor, you are going to receive recovery now. You must know when it started. You must know how it started for you to be able to understand the strategy to employ. Until you are furnished with knowledge, until you are furnished with knowledge, there is no victory at stake. Psalm 144 verse 1. Because every battle has its own strategy. Blessed be the Lord, my strength, which teacheth my hands to war and my fingers to fight. Sir, don't use the drug for stomach ache to cure headache. If you use it, you damage the body the more. Because you must have the right knowledge of exactly what is going on in your life for you to be able to fix it. If you are not schooled, you cannot be acquainted with the strategies. That's why David said, he teacheth my hand to war. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13. But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. It is very easy for you to see Christians that are ignorant. In this time and age, that's when you see them crying like every other person. They say, this Nigeria is killing us. This Nigeria is this. The economy is hard. If the economy is hard, does it dictate that your life should be hard? Please, did you hear what I just said? When did you start to bank your prosperity on Nigeria economy? Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, far above. Buhari does not even have the inclination of the level of prosperity that is at stake for you. For blessed be God the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who had blessed us with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3. So you must understand that the template on which your prosperity will ride is not going to be bordered and shouldered on the Nigerian economy. When you begin to earn more than your salary, then you know God is at work. When you begin to earn more than your boss, then you know that God is at work. Imagine your salary on 150,000 naira and you went to go and buy a car of 5 million or 6 million. You bring it to work. Not that your husband dash you, but you know that this one a God provider. And then you get to the office, your boss pack a range, you too, you pack your range beside. Let me tell you, from that time, you're a threat. They either sack you or frustrate you. Can I prophesy to somebody here? In the name that is above every other name, every limitation around your life is broken. Look at your amen. Every limitation around your life is broken. Your prosperity will swallow up that company. Your wealth will buy that company. Let me hear your amen if you're a dangerous believer. Quickly, what is stronghold? Stronghold is anything or any force that is stronger than you. Who will enter a strong man's house that will not first bind him before he gain possession to what belongs to him. There are battles that we contend with that looks a little bit stronger than us. Now, it has stayed with you for the number of years you've lived on earth. You know what I'm talking about. And until you engage the faith in God to activate your inheritance in Christ, you may not be able to conquer that stronghold. Some of us who've been battling with poverty from the generation we didn't even know where they are coming from. We met poverty, and poverty has decided to settle with us all these years. Now, it has become a threat to the next generation because they can't go to good school. You keep withdrawing them from one school to the other because we are looking for cheaper school. So where they are supposed to know 2 times 2 times 2, and then they say 2 times 2 4 4 times 2 8, in a school where there is, where poverty is the governor of that governing board here, you ask a child 2 times 2, he says 6. Because it has happened to me. I went to a public school such that poverty was our principal, not even the man. When we wrote WAEC, all of us, we gathered Fatai, F9, raised to power 2. Nobody escaped it. My vocal cord, my communication skill became affected because we were only speaking panavula, or what they call it, vernacular. We were speaking, so I'm being conscious. You come on, baby, come on. English teacher is coming to talk in Yoruba. Does he send you? She doesn't send you. After all, it's your parents that brought you. They didn't write an invitation letter to come and invite you. Daddy, because of the environment that God has blessed us, my son, less than 3, he speaks some things that I say, eh? You? One day I asked him, I said, son, when did you start this? He did something like that. I said, when did you start? He said, now. And when he said now, he went away. Can I prophesy to you? In the name that is above every other name, every stronghold in your life that manage the activities of your family, if your amen can be the loudest, I pull them down. I pull them down. There are some family that go through delay, 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 delay in education, delay in finances, delay in marriage, delay in childbearing, delay in wealth, delay. I decree every satanic stronghold over your marriage today, if your amen can be the loudest, I command them to be pulled down. I command them to be pulled down. There are families that all of them in that family don't have passports to travel. They don't even know where the airport is. It is because there are strongholds that need to be cleared. Otherwise, the destiny of people in that family will not rise. Can I decree to somebody? It has happened to me. I never made passport with my father. My father never showed us airport. My father never, never, never flew all his life. He's over 60 now. He has. If he will fly tomorrow, it will be me. When I grew in that atmosphere, I knew I'm to start a new generation. Oh, yes. I made up my mind. I'm not going to continue this nonsense. Somebody said nonsense. Nonsense. I didn't hear you. Nonsense. I didn't hear you. Nonsense. Anything that will not make sense in your future is called nonsense. Anything that is contrary to God's plan in your life is called nonsense. Anything that the devil is doing in your life is called nonsense. I went. I took, but got a passport for almost 4 years before the thing expired. No visa. I said, lie. I took the passport. came to my two here. Please show me the bus going to Ghana. I'm not ready to wait for nonsense. I'm not ready to wait for. I'm not ready to wait for. They say, wait. Let our first daughter, let her get married before you get married. Somebody said, nonsense. That culture will not stand. The Lord is your culture. He made the first to be the last. The last to be the first. He raised the poor from the dust. He raised the beggar from the dunghill. And put them on the throne. Let me prophesy in the name that is above every other name. Nothing will stop your destiny. Nothing will stop your destiny. Can I hear your amen like a thunder? Quickly, how do we assess this victory? Ephesians chapter 6, verse 16. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 16. My goodness. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench. Oh! Is it some? Eh? Say it, let all the witches in this church hear you. Oh, the fiery darts of the wicked. Sir, I respect grace. But let me tell you the dimension that they are taking it. If we are not careful, they are driving the church to a sleeping mode. Because there are certain things that you cannot just allow them to happen. You have to make them happen. Don't tell me because oxygen is in this house. Oh boy. If you don't breathe. Imagine you are looking and saying, meek, grace is, oxygen is here. If you like, enter. If you like, don't enter. You are here. You may not even finish this service before they carry you out. Imagine you, there's a food on the table. You are not ready to eat. Unfortunately, I can't eat for you. Unfortunately, nobody can eat for you. If you must grow, you must eat. Grace is the atmosphere where God has brought us in, where we can swim in the finished work of Christ. But sir, until you take it, they cannot be captured. And faith above all, taking the shield of faith. Wherewith you quench every fiery dart of the devil. Let me quickly run through the nature of the kind of faith that will deliver your victory to you. Because when we are talking about faith, it's a whole lot. But you see, you need to capture this nature for you to be able to base your faith on them and begin to action some certain things in your life. Number one, the kind of faith that will deliver your victory to you is what I call daring faith. The faith that does not settle down for less. The faith that dares to fix. Daniel chapter 3 from verse 16. Three Hebrew guys. They brought them interface with a judgment. Because they refused to bow to the system that the people of that time were submitting to. And then they tried to threaten them. Say, listen. If you don't do it this time, we are going to cast you into the fiery furnace of fire. Those guys, they say, not today. We know what we are doing here. They say, oh, ye king, we are not careful to answer you in this matter. Go back. Let me put it on the screen. Let me see. Daniel chapter 3, verse 16. We are not careful to answer you in this manner. Verse 17. For if it be so, our God. Somebody say, our God. Louder, say, our God. Whom we serve is able to deliver.
us from the burning fiery furnace. And he will deliver us from your hand. Daring faith cannot be threatened. When you are hearing rumor, they want to downsize. They want to downsize. Say, and so what? It's just to tell us to go back to our houses. Nothing missing. Nothing broken. They say, you are talking about. I say, what? The earth is the Lord and the fullness there. My portion is bigger than this company. It's not a do or die affair. It is where you place your life. Oh, you say, they about to say, Pastor, please help me to pray. They are downsizing so that my name will not be in it. Please pray. Yeah, prayer points. God never say we prosper you in that company. He say we prosper you in all that you do. Why don't you do something else? Am I talking to somebody here? Daring faith will face the labor market and fix it. Daring faith will step out of this church today and go and register a company to start to fly a business. Daring faith will go to lands and begin to price even when there is no money in the pocket. Daring faith will go to where they are selling cars, because the car you are driving now needs to be changed. Any car you open the bonnet to check the water, to check the oil, to check that car needs deliverance. Before the thing breaks down, you need another one. Am I talking to somebody here? It's like you, your phone, you put sellotape. They say, why are you burning? They say, this phone, all my contacts is inside. God will punish every devil of poverty in your life. Can I hear your amen louder? The next one is speaking faith. Romans chapter 10 verse 8. Romans chapter 10 verse 8. But what saith it? The word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth and in thy heart. That is the word of faith which we preach. Please put on the screen Luke chapter 21 verse 15. Let them see. Luke 21 verse 15. For I will give you a mouth. Somebody say a mouth. Oh, please come on, say it loud and clear. Say a mouth. I will give you a mouth and wisdom, which all your adversaries or your enemies shall not be able to gainsay. God will punish every devil in your life. Can I hear your amen louder? Are you ready to use your mouth? Are you ready to use your mouth? When I release you to open your mouth, you release the missile bomb. All the witches in this church, congratulations, you are dead today. Then let me send an advance notice to all the witches in your father's house and your mother's house. They must be ready to die today. If you are a killer, let me hear you say amen. He said, suffer the witch not to do what? Not to do what? Not to do what? Anybody that say your water will not boil, anybody that is waiting for your tears to drop, anybody that say you'll be going from one hospital on behalf of your children, anybody that want to make your husband to be useless, any woman, any lady of any type that is pinging, chatting, women say Holy Ghost. Woo! Today is today. Every enemy must bow. If you believe that, come and shout hallelujah. Sir, in this kingdom, it is your sound that commands the signs. If you are soundless, you'll be signless. That is why, don't let the devil get you to a point where you no longer speak anymore. Your faith, if it is a real one, it must not be a crying faith, but a speaking faith. Whose report will you believe? The report of the Lord. The report of the Lord says, even though you are weak, but you are strong. Even though you look poor, but you are rich. Let me prophesy to you. Today, you are changing your location. You are moving to the higher level. You are moving to the next phase of your life. You are moving from singlehood to marriagehood. Let me hear your amen if you are a believer. Except I am not sent to you, before the end of this month, a miracle will show up in your life. The door that your certificate cannot open, within the next 3 months, it shall be open to you. Let me hear the amen of believers in the house. They say you are not qualified, but God is the qualifier. Can I prophesy to you? Receive grace, receive favor, receive grace, receive favor, receive grace, receive favor. Anytime you are going to bank, anytime you are going to bank, and you know what you have in your account, and you don't like what you have in your account, as they open the gate, the security man say, "You're welcome, good money." As they open that bullet, that thing that turned like Chia Baba. As you enter, say, "I've come to take over this bank." I am a multi-millionaire. Oh boy, you are still feeling your deposit of 7,500. You are still on the queue. Say, this bank belongs to me. The economy of this bank belongs to me. Is somebody hearing me today? As you step out of this door, my God will organize a miracle for you. If you are the one, let your amen be standing. If you are the one, let your amen be jumping. If you are the one, let your amen be jumping. The higher your height, the faster you catch on the network. The louder your amen, the better your breakthrough. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Sit down. The last faith is the action faith. I'm done, yes, sir. The action faith. The action faith is the faith that is put into motion. If sickness is threatening your body, don't sleep on your bed and be claiming your healing. One of the antidotes against sickness is to move. The moment you stand from your bed and you take a walk, 10 minutes, and you begin to speak, "I am here. No more sickness. My body is coming back to normal." Even if you cannot walk very well, you are just, "I am ill. I am okay. The power of God is in me." Oh boy. Before you return back to the same bed, the sickness has disappeared. Because of why? Don't tell me your faith can work when you are not walking with it. James 2 verse 20 to 26, when you get home, you read it. Any faith that is not actioned is dead. Is dead. And any dead faith cannot produce. Are you ready to fight the battle this morning? Rise on your feet this morning. Because Agbaranla Owa Ninu Agoi, the mighty power of God is heavy in this house. And you must engage it, because your inheritance must be delivered to you. Lift your two hands, the 125 of you here. I'd like you to say with me, say, "Father." I didn't hear you loud. I said, "Father, I receive my inheritance.
over the strongholds of my life. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. In 1 minute, come on. Come on. Come on. Don't let your voice be affected by your problem. Lift your voice. Jesus' mighty name we pray. Oh yeah, lift your two hands. Where are the 125 of you here? Lift your two hands. Say with me. Say, Father, I arrest. Look, I want you to do it like a champion. Say, Father, I arrest all my arresters. Father, I arrest every force that has vowed that I will not go forward. What are you waiting for? Lift up the voice. Come on. Come on. Are you sure you're praying? You have 29 seconds to deal with this right now. Woo! If you're a firstborn, make sure that you are praying this prayer, because the devil is after your status. You must move ahead. You have 5 seconds. Tighten it up. Ah. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Can I hear the amen of 125 champions? This is the last prayer point. Say with me, say, Father. Louder than your neighbor, say, Father. Every evil altar that is fighting against my testimony, what are you waiting for? Catch fire. Lift up your voice in 30 seconds. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Every altar that receives sacrifice, that receives sacrifices on your behalf, Lord, we command fire, 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 fire. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. If your amen can be the loudest in three times, you are the one that heaven is going to open over. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Come on. One more time. Come on. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Say with me, say, my matter is settled. Oh, yes. You have to say it one more time. Say, my matter is settled. I was praying this morning, and the Holy Ghost ministered this to me, that I should anoint 125 of you. Listen. Listen, anytime a prophet is sent to you, he leaves an instruction with you for you to comply. Your compliance with that instruction gives you your distinction. Within 72 hours, you will put a seed of 21,000 on this altar. Come and meet me here. Wherever you are, you will put a seed of 21,000 on this altar. Come and meet me here. It's a seed of victory. And you must suspend your mind
when it comes to you connecting to the grace that is not common. Because a new calendar is about to open up for you. Listen, until your mind is suspended, you become the most foolish person in the entire city. Because there are certain things your mind cannot carry because they are too bigger than them. You can't buy the anointing, no way. But every opportunity for you to connect, please do, because you don't know the seed that will break the siege. Up till today, there are some places that have erosion. Till tomorrow, rain will still continue to fall. Because the day rain stopped to fall, because it is too much on earth, that is the time famine begin to come. Who told you that God cannot mess up the plan of the devil in your life? Papa didn't tell me this. I was praying this morning, and the Lord said, just 21,000 naira as a seed of victory. Listen, I perceive that there are monies that are tied down that need to be released. And you have called, you have sent messages, you have done this, you have done that, you have even bribed, let me use that word. But yet, they are still hanging because of what? Because you are yet to hit the target, to change the strategy that will deliver your success to you. Please, if you are coming, come quick before I pray. And let me say this to you. The body of Christ is infiltrated with people who are not sincere with their God. It's the reason why the altars we rear up don't work. People come out this way to show their faces, but yet they try to sit back and expect something to happen. Don't do it, because you came out by yourself. And you have 72 hours. If you have it today, drop it so that the thing can be actioned immediately. Are you hearing me? You have it tomorrow, but latest by Tuesday night, even if you are not going to be here, send it to somebody. I don't know, how did they, into the account, or they bring it here? Into the account, or they bring it here? Either of the two. If you are sending it to the account, make sure you give it a reference. My seed of victory. And when you are bringing it, write it at the back of the envelope. My seed of victory. Are you hearing me? Lift your two hands. Lift your two hands. I don't know how they can count this number. If they are up to 125. I don't know if they can count this number. There are still some set of people sitting looking at me. Say, me ajade. Like, never. For what? That devil is a liar. Tell him too, for what? Why wouldn't I step out? The people that step out, do they have two heads? I believe, even if it does not make sense, I believe this is my own breakthrough. Yes. Lift your two hands to heaven. Put me on string, son. God bless you. I decree over your life, in the name that is above every other name, this seed will break the siege. Amen. Did you hear me? I decree again, this seed will break the siege. Amen. Where they expect you to beg to survive, miraculously, mighty doors of abundance will open for you. Stretch forth your hand towards me here. I command the 125 of you here to receive what money cannot buy. Let your amen be the loudest. Let your amen be the loudest. As I touch your right palm, you lay it on your head and you walk to your seat. Believe God that with men it is impossible, not with God. For with God, all things are possible. Your landed property will be signed. Your landed property will be handed over to you. That house will be completed. The next promotion, instead of downsizing, it will be your name. Can I hear your amen louder? Please lead us in worship as I do minister to them quickly.
Yes, you are the Lord Most High. Yes, you are the Lord Most High, I'm saying,
yes, you are the Lord. Most High, yes, you are the Lord. Most High,
touch me with your hand, oh Lord, touch me with your hand. Oh Lord, touch me with your hands, Jesus. Oh Lord, touch me with your hands. Oh Lord, I don't wanna go the same way I came. Touch me with your hand. Oh Lord, I don't wanna go the same way I came. Touch me with your hand. Oh Lord, I don't wanna go. I don't wanna go. I don't want to go. Touch me with your hand. Oh, touch me, Lord.
Touch me with your hand.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord.
Touch me, Lord.
Touch me with your hand.
Sweet Spirit of
God. Oh,
come and do a miracle today. Come and do a miracle today. Miracle walker,
miracle walker,
you are
miracle walker.
Come and do, Lord,
come and do a miracle today.
Oh Lord,
come and do a miracle today.
Destiny changer,
destiny changer,
you are
destiny changer.
Oh Lord,
come and do a destiny today.
Yeah, give me.
Naya na kipe Ombu onye soko Agama ho
Iyekebe
Iyekebe
Nantawa chineke
Ayamuga ho
Iyekebe
Iyekebe
Nantawa chineke
Ayamuga ho Iyekebe
Iyekebe Nantawa chineke
Lift your hands to heaven. I decree with your loud amen that hand will not wither financially. What you have not been able to do with those hands, by the anointing, go and start to do them. Let me hear your amen like a thunder. Lift up your hand and shout three powerful hallelujah.
Oh, Iyekebe.
The same way you came. If you know you have no relationship with Jesus, you are never giving your life at any time to Jesus. I don't want you to have a carryover of what has been released from people into your life. For you to have the victory and for the victory to be permanent, you need Jesus in your life. You are here under this anointing and you want to say, Jesus, I come to you, I want to surrender. Can I see your hands up? Just lift your hand. Thank you, my brother. Any other person? Thank you. Please come forward. Come forward. Come forward. Yes, come forward. Let your victory be permanent today. Come to Jesus today. Seal it. Seal it permanently. So that you can live here and fulfill destiny. I'm still waiting for you. I'm still waiting for you. There's still more. You want to fulfill destiny. You want your victory to be sealed today. Please come. Come. Praise the Lord. Church, let's stretch our hands to these people and pray for them. Ask that the Lord will save them. That the Lord will accept them today. He will forgive their sins. He will wipe out all their sins and write their names in the book of life. That the power of sin over them is broken today. And they will live in total victory from today onwards. In the name of Jesus. I pray for you that as I've come today, the Lord will accept you. He will write your names in the book of life. In the name of Jesus. Today you begin to live a new life in Him. And your victory will be complete. in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. We're giving you Bibles to start your life. Reading the Bibles is being presented to you by the church. And as you read and meditate every day on it, your life will not be the same again. Together. You see my sister holding counselor board there. Please follow her. It will take you, take your names and your prayer requests, and we'll be praying for you all along. Church, let's clap for them. You can do better.